A Michigan beauty pageant winner, an outspoken supporter of President Trump, has her crown revoked. She claims it was over her political views. Kathy Ju was abruptly stripped of her title of Miss Michigan last week after some past tweets came to the attention of pageant officials. And Kathy Ju joins us now. Kathy, thanks for being here. So just to get the story straight, the pageant officials said that they found your social media content to be offensive, insensitive, and inappropriate. Do you see why they felt that way?
Honestly, you shouldn't just take, you know, tweets out of context. I think it's super important to full context of the tweet and the full conversation. Everything I've posted was my statistics and opinions. And I think that, you know, we should be empowering women's voices and not just stripping them of their title only because of their opinions.
So let's look at some of your posts that I think that they had objections to. So here was one. This was from October 2017. I think it was in reference to some conversation about Black Lives Matter. You wrote, "Did you know the majority of black deaths are caused by other blacks? Fix problems within your own community first before blaming others." So do you see how that could be seen as offensive?
You know, this tweet was actually in response to another person talking about how all blacks or all cops are bad people, that they kill innocent black people. And I think that you shouldn't just put a blanket statement over all cops. You know, again, read full tweets and context to make sure to see the full story.
Yeah, but I mean, I guess your point of, did you know the majority of black deaths are caused by other blacks? What's your point?
That's a statistic. So you could find that on FBI's website. This is all backed up by statistics and facts. I think it's really, really awful how the left thinks that statistics and facts are racist. So I don't think anything I said was remotely wrong. I stand by every tweet that I post.
And do you know who causes the majority of white deaths?
Yeah, this is, apparently this is white people cause white deaths. It's not even that's the issue. The issue is that people didn't know that I was responding to another person calling cops bad people.
Right. I guess my point is, why would you focus on blacks causing black deaths when the majority of white deaths are caused by white people? Why, you know, this is why people think that that has a ring of racism to it. You didn't mention the white statistic.
Again, this is in response to another person's tweet talking about how cops kill black people. And this is, you know, I can't just take a tweet and just, you know, turn it around saying, oh, white and white violence too. Of course, everyone has problems with their own communities, and I completely understand that. But, you know, we have to empower women's voices, honestly, to show that, you know, we could have different political opinions and that not just statistics and facts are racist.
Well, first of all, the pageant wasn't calling you racist. They were saying insensitive and offensive content. And again, you're the person who focused in on that statistic. That's the statistic that you decided to highlight instead of police excessive force showing those statistics. And so this is what got the attention of pageant officials.
You know, that's actually false, because if you read the text through the state director, she actually quoted the tweet that I said and called and said, is this racist? This is racist, right? I mean, you know, again, this is taken fully out of context. And I think that, you know, if you actually think that statistics and facts are racist, I don't know what to tell you. I think,
no,
again,
it's just
we
which
should...
ones you highlight. I mean, it's just which ones you highlight, since, you know, you could have said the thing about white people. But let's move on to your next tweet. And that was about Hijab Awareness Day. And so you
yes.
wrote here, there's a try a hijab on booth at my college campus. So you're telling me that it's now just a fashion accessory and not a religious thing? Or are you just trying to get women used to being oppressed under Islam? Again, what would you like to say about that? You don't see how that could be offensive?
Not at all. They were, you know, I went past the booth. I was late for class already. They were saying, do you want to put on a hijab, putting it, you know, over me? I said, no, I don't want to. I declined wearing this, you know, garment. I think that, you know, it's really rude, I feel like, to Muslims, too, that, you know, to wear their sacred garment on someone who isn't a Muslim themselves. You know, I wouldn't want to put, you know, a Catholic rosary on someone if they aren't Catholic.
Right, but
so
that's
not
what you said. What you said, it wasn't that you felt badly for them that you weren't Muslim. It's that you said, or are you just trying to get women used to being oppressed under Islam?
Yes, there are so many women in Muslim countries right now who are being stoned to death because they don't want to wear a hijab due to their husband's requirement to do so. And I think that we should be focusing on that way more than the Western things about Muslim, because, you know, there's so many bad things happening in Muslim countries because of these, you know, women, and these women are being, you know, crucified for not wearing a hijab, and I think that's really, really awful.
Okay, Kathy Zhu, thank you for coming on New Day
thank
to make
me.
Your case.